legislature to be a more effective body. His door is open to each and every one of us, and he will facilitate our efforts to faithfully serve the residents of Orange County. For these reasons, I am proud to nominate L. Stephen Brescia as chairman of the Orange County Legislature.
Do you have a second? Mr. Fagio?
Thank you. It is my pleasure to sit here today and second the nomination of L. Stephen Brescia for chairman of the Orange County Legislature. Steve has been a man that I've been able to go to ask tough questions and get honest answers in a fair and reasonable manner. It is that reason why I second the nomination of L. Stephen Brescia for chairman of the Orange County Legislature.
The name of L. Stephen Brescia has been presented as chairman for the year 2018. Are there any other nominations? There being no other nominations, may I have a motion to close nominations?
So moved.
I cast one ballot for L. Stephen Brescia as chairman of the Orange County Legislature. Is there a second?
Second.
All in favor?
Aye.
Anyone opposed? L. Stephen Brescia has been elected as chairman of the Orange County Legislature for the year 2018.
Thank you.
Brescia.
Do solemnly swear.
Do solemnly swear.
To support the Constitution of the United States.
To support the Constitution of the United States.
The Constitution of the State of New York.
The Constitution of the State of New York.
That I will faithfully discharge the duties of.
That I will faithfully discharge the duties of Chairman of the Legislature.
According to the best of my ability.
According to the best of my ability.
So help me God.
So help me God.
Thank you. Thank you, everyone. I'd like to welcome the new legislators, incoming legislators. I think we have a great team coming in. I'm energized. I'm looking forward to it. I think we're going to have a good 4 years and do a lot of things to accomplish. I know the first year when I came in as chairman in 2014 was a year of deadlock. It was grueling. It was horrible. As county exec, and I would both like to put it in the rearview mirror, and I think we did. We got quite a bit accomplished in the last 3 years and a little bit in that first year. We were able to do the beach agreement on the palm tree resolution, which I think eases tensions down in that area of the county and in other areas of the county. We were able to do 4 early retirement incentives / separation agreements, saving the county in excess of $18 million. And we did this in bipartisan fashion. We didn't just do it. It wasn't one party. It was 3 parties in this legislature, the county exec and his staff, commissioners and department heads and so on and so forth. And I'm very proud of that. We were able to reach compromise on this government center, a beautiful government center it is. It's not what everybody envisioned from the start, but I think it's going to be useful. It's going to consolidate office space, save the taxpayers money. So, I look forward to working with each and every one of you. I see some dignitaries out in the audience. I see Mayor Joe DiStefano out there. The bishop, they call him. And Joel, are those your groupies out there with fire uniforms on, probably?
Yeah.
Who else am I missing out there? Bill Kaplan, we're going to do a presentation with him shortly. Charlie Barnes, supervisor, town of Crawford, is out there. Tony Cardone, who's supervisor of town of Monroe. Did I miss anybody? Oh, Judge Onofre, I'm sorry. Judge Bob Onofre, you report to us. We're behind the camp, behind Rodney's judge, I can't see, I'm sorry. But I'm real happy that we're ready to get started. Looking forward to working with each and every one of you. Many of you have great ideas. I met with Mike Paduke in the office downstairs in the snowstorm yesterday. We had good conversation. Wants to push forward some initiatives from the Democratic caucus. Talked about the park plan committee for improving Hillhold and the Brick House Museum, things with facilities and treasures that the county has that having been, you know, they've been neglected because of money situations. We have a lot of good initiatives out there. John Bureau would like to do more at the airport based on the plan that they came up with, the airport committee. And then Jim O'Donnell would like to do school security throughout the county. Rob Sassy and I talked yesterday, and he would like to be involved with the opioid crisis in Orange County. He's seen some of it firsthand, some of his former students, and it's a really poignant discussion with him, and he'd like to dig in and do whatever we can in that regard. But there's so many other initiatives. I know Joe Menuto wants to get a little think tank of the legislature going, and I'm open to all that. I always have been. You know, like I said, these initiatives that we do, and even Valerie, I heard discussion here. I see the Facebook blogs and some of the stuff that's said out there. There's nobody here pushing to sell value anymore. It's not, you know, so just let's get that fear out of the way. We need to appoint a committee to look at value and try to come up with some reasonable ideas to develop the property out there to help support value, whether it's senior housing or pharmacy or whatever, and get a whole group of individuals in to look at this. But, and Camp LaGuardia, we all want to do something with Camp LaGuardia. Let's do it. Let's do it. Let's look to the county exec for bringing us some ideas, and we can get things done. The parks commissioner, I think the county had, county exec has a couple of good candidates for us to look at. We're ready to appoint a parks commissioner and move things forward. The Heritage Trail is going to be a huge project. I know Joe DiStefano pushes hard on that. It's going to be good for Walk Hill, Goshen, Middletown, and so many other areas of the county. And we're ready to get started on that. So without further ado, let's move forward. Okay, roll call, Kelly.
Ava?
Here.
Anastasis?
Present.
Okay.
Here.
Benelli?
Here.
Gresham?
Here.
Jane?
Here.
Gresham?
Here.
Heinz?
Here.
Kulissa?
Here.
Luhon?
Here.
Menuda?
Here.
O'Donnell?
Here.
Padu?
Here.
Miscavige?
Here.
Sassy?
Here.
Sierra?
Here.
Kiranga?
Here.
Sutherland?
Here.
Tocca?
Here.
Tui?
Here.
Zero.
Here.
I was remiss in not thanking my two sons, Vincent and Nicholas, who we call Seek and Destroy around the Gresham House. They're old to 530 now. They're old about my sister Stacy and my mother, Phyllis, is here as well. Thank you to my family members. And I forgot to mention Michael Amo, too, about, you know, we talked about the palm tree, and I know he wants to see initiatives to suit intentions in other areas of the county, too, such as Deer Park and a few other areas. Without further ado, Jean Burley. Number one. You have to point me, right?
Legislator Benelli, resolution appointing clerk of the county legislature pursuant to section 2.06 of the county charter of the county of Orange, local law number 8 of the year 1968.
Second.
Discussion, Mike.
May I please?
Yes.
All Dems?
All Dems. All Republicans. So be it.
Benelli?
Aye.
Padu?
Here.
Aye.
Amo?
Yes.
Anastasis? Benton? Cheney? Fagio? Heinz? Kulissa? Luhon?
Aye.
Menuda? O'Donnell? Riskevich? Sassy?
Yes.
Sierra? Stiganga? Sutherland? Tortel?
Aye.
Tui? Vero? Gresham? 21 ayes. Thank you.
Great, congratulations. Discussion. Roll.
pursuant to section 214 of the county law.
Second.
Orange County Post, News of the Highlands, Times Community Newspapers for concurrent resolutions, election notices, Orange County Post, Times Community Newspapers, News of the Highlands, Warwick Advertiser, Photo News, Warwick Valley Dispatch, and Times Herald Record.
Second. Okay, discussion. Roll call. Number five.
Designation by members of the county legislature representing the Democratic Party of newspapers to publish the concurrent resolutions of the state legislature and election notices to be published in 2018 pursuant to section 214 of the county law. Goshen Independent, Hudson Valley Press, Times Community Newspapers, Times Herald Record, Goshen Independent, Hudson Valley News.
Second.
Okay. Receiving file. Okay, number six.
Designation by members of the county legislature representing the Republican Party of newspapers to publish all local laws, notices, and other matters required by law to be published in 2018 pursuant to subdivision 2 of section 214 of the county law.
Second.
Official newspapers of the county legislature of the county of Orange, all local laws, notices, and other matters required to be published by the county legislature, the Orange County Post, Warwick Advertiser, Photo News, News of the Highlands, and Warwick Valley Dispatch.
Okay, receiving file. Number seven.
Designation by members of the county legislature representing the Democratic Party of newspapers to publish all local laws, notices, and other matters required by law to be published in 2018 pursuant to subdivision 2 of section 214 of the county law. Official newspapers of the county legislature of the county of Orange, all local laws, notices, and other matters required to be published by the county legislature, Times Community Newspapers, Hudson Valley Press.
Second.
Receiving file. Okay, number eight.
Legislator Benelli, resolution designating newspapers published within the county as official newspapers for the publication of all local laws, notices, and other matters required by law to be published in 2018, pursuant to subdivision 2 of section 214 of the county law.
Okay, receiving file. Oh, this is roll call? Okay, roll call, I'm sorry.
Benelli?
Aye.
Paduk?
Aye.
Aimo?
Aye.
Anagostakis? Benton? Cheney? Fagione? Hines? Kulisek? Luhan? Menuda? O'Donnell? Miscavige? Sassy? Sierra? Skaganga? Sutherland? Quartel? Tui? Vera? Gresham? 21 ayes.
Okay, we've got two proclamations, and also at the end we have a presentation from the school. That's three schools in there.
I don't see them.
Pardon?
I don't see them.
They're not going to be here, you don't think? Okay. All right, so the first up, we have a presentation for Linda Romato of Newburgh, named Teacher of the Year by the Association for Career and Technical Education. That's a national award, right?
Yes.
So I'd like to invite up the County Executive, Legislator Kevin Dowery, excuse me, Lou John from the City of Newburgh, Legislator Jim Kulisek from the City of Newburgh, Legislator Jim O'Donnell, who's very involved down there, and who else? Joe Menuda is on the school board. So
yeah.
Mr. Captain, of course.
Thanks.
joining the National Association of Career and Technical Education's 2018 National Teacher of the Year Award. And whereas Romano has demonstrated innovation in the classroom and a commitment to her students during her distinguished career, and whereas Romano started a nurse aid program at Newburgh Free Academy that has grown from 12 students in 2006 to 214 students today. Graduates have become key members of local healthcare of workforce. And whereas Romano splits her time between Newburgh Classroom and Alliant Incorporated, where she works with students so they can develop their classroom taught skills and become professional caregivers. And whereas Romano has also chaired the school's building leadership team, co-chaired the health and safety team, organized blood drives, and conducted CPR AED training for students and staff. She also mentors new teachers and participates extensively in professional development. And whereas, I now know why you told me because I'm running out of saliva here. Thanks. And whereas Romano serves as teacher and team leader for Scholars and Scrubs, one of the newest classes in the Newburgh Armory Unity Center's Saturday Enrichment Program. It is a collaboration between the nursing program at Mount St. Mary College and St. Luke's Cornwall Hospital. And whereas Romano has chaired the school's building leadership team, co-chaired the health and safety team, organized numerous blood drives, conducted, that was the AED, it's on there again, so I'm just going with it, training for the staff and students, and written curriculum for the nursing program. And whereas Romano is an active member of numerous state and national professional organizations and has presented at numerous conferences. She has served on several state education department and Department of Health work groups, writing and mapping curriculum. Now, therefore, be resolved that I, Stephen M. Newhouse, Orange County Executive, and Chairman of the Legislature, L. Stephen Brescia, in recognition of her hard work and numerous activities, do hereby honor Linda Romano throughout Orange County and call upon the people of our county to extend Mrs. Romano the blessings of their hospitality and gratitude, deserving of her many accomplishments. And it's signed and dated today. Congratulations.
Absolutely amazing what's going on down there. Thank you.
person that comes in. I had an opportunity to go and actually see this in person, and it's absolutely extraordinary. You can't, it's not enough to talk about it in words. You have to come by and visit yourselves. This is the kind of program you want to see in every city, in every town, because it's really changing the way we look at our youth. Thank you so much.
Well, I'd be remiss not to say something as a member of the school board for Newburgh Marcy School District. And I want to thank you from the bottom of our heart and the entire district, actually, for raising the bar within Newburgh Schools and raising it to a national level. We have the skills, we have the technology, we have the programs. People need to start looking at that and recognizing it for what it truly is. I want to thank Mr. Kaplan. He's invited me to the Armory several times, and it is amazing what is going on there. The children are learning coding in the third grade, I believe it is. Chess is, the chess program is absolutely packed. I don't think there's any more room. So, oh, you have plenty of room. Okay, so fair enough. But anyway, the things that are happening in the Newburgh and Lawrence Hughes School District area, the help of these two, we're just raising the bar, and I couldn't be more proud. So thank you so much for your commitment and your service.
Okay. across America and speak to some of the young men and women that they're mentoring. And just like Linda has changed a lot of people's lives, the Boys and Girls Club, and in particular the one in Newburgh, I see in Harry Ford, who lives in the city of Newburgh, and obviously are two county legislators as well as around the county where they have programs, knows the men. Some of the young kids that they have there have really no other mentors than what you guys provide. And I'm proud to stand here with the county legislature and the chairman to honor you. Do you want to have Jim, the city of Newburgh legislators up here with us as well, or whoever else that has been helpful? We do support the program. We've been talking about continuing to increase it, and I think it's a well-worth cause. And just like some of the speakers mentioned about the armory, when you step foot in the armory, you see people's lives change, and then you have to be there physically to experience what they do. The same thing with your what you provide, the young men and women, and seeing the inspiration on their faces. It's really one of the things that started our hunger program here. When I spoke at one of their Boys and Girls Club, Read Across America, the kid asked me if I was a police officer because his father was incarcerated and he wanted his dad home for Christmas. And he had no family. And that is the sad story to a lot of young men and women across this country, but including in this county. And you guys are really sometimes the only spot they have to get that mentorship. So I'm very proud to stand here with Boys and Girls Club and to honor you for Mentoring Month. Steve, you want me to read the proclamation and then we'll? Okay. So this is National Mentoring Month. Whereas the Big Brothers, Big Sisters of Orange County mentoring model is a proven, effective strategy that helps children and young adults by matching them with a caring, responsible adult role model who can provide guidance and direction and build their confidence. And whereas mentoring strengthens Orange County's economic and social well-being by helping young people fulfill potential, encouraging healthy family relationships, and promoting more vibrant communities. And whereas residents of Orange County are making a profound difference in the lives of our young people by serving as mentors, and whereas thousands of Orange County's children are in need of a caring adult mentor in their lives, and closing the mentoring gap will take more investment, partnerships, volunteers ready to make the difference in a child's life. And whereas National Mentoring Month is an opportunity to raise public awareness of the importance of mentoring, recognize the dedicated individuals who serve as mentors, and encourage more citizens to help build a brighter future for Orange County's youth through mentoring. And whereas, in honor of the mentors, volunteers, and staff, the month of January is recognized nationally as Mentoring Month. Now, therefore, be it resolved that I, County Executive Steve Newhouse, and Legislative Chairman L. Stephen Brescia, pay tribute to the work of Big Brothers, Big Sisters as they help the young people of our community thrive by observing January 2008 as National Mentoring Month in Orange County, and encourage county employees to volunteer their free time to be used by mentoring. Congratulations.
Thank you. So I'd like to take this opportunity to thank County Executive Mr. Newhouse and the County Legislature for supporting Big Brothers and Big Sisters of Orange County and the work that we do. One of the things that we're very passionate about is that there is not one single adult in this room who can't say that there was someone who helped them to become the person they are today. That was your mentor. It could have been a coach, it could have been a neighbor, it could have been a barber, it could have been just the guy standing on the corner. But whatever they've done, they've shaped you to become the person that you are. And we're hoping that through this recognition for National Mentoring Month, that we can encourage more adults become mentors and make the difference in a young person's life. So thank you once again for this opportunity and for this recognition. We really appreciate it.
Thank you.
Everybody stay assigned to the desk.